Good evening to everyone. My name is Meher. I am a legal intern with Lexis & Company, also a third year law student at DME Law College, Noida. In this video, I am going to be further talking about more such unitary functions, and it is a continued part of the previous video. Non-equal representations in Rajya Sabha, that is mentioned in Schedule 4. The states are given representation in Rajya Sabha on the basis of population, hence membership varies from 1 to 31. In contradiction to the US Senate, equality of representation of states in upper house, 2 members from every state. Example is Jammu and Kashmir. Now let's talk about financial relations. Constitution separates the heads of taxation in union and states by division in list 1 and 2. No concurrent jurisdiction of taxation, residuary power of taxation vests with the parliament. Article 247. No bill can be moved or amended. Amendment can be introduced on any subject of levy of taxes on the recommendation of president in the case of center or governor in the case of state. As we have already discussed earlier, governor acts as a representative of the president, so henceforth president has the control over the taxation in states as well, more or less. Financial control over states. Now if we talk about financial control and financial emergency, in case of financial instability can be passed, an emergency can be passed under Article 360. All the money bill passed by state legislatures during emergency are also subjected to control of the center. Now, single citizenship. We are going to be discussing a few more such features of our constitution that states that union government or the parliament has more control than the state governments. So single citizenship, dual polity with single citizenship. Every person residing has the same citizenship rights no matter in which state he she resides or where he she resides. No state citizenship is allowed in India, and this provision is contrary to the US. In US, there is a policy of dual citizenship. Power, now the other feature, power to the center to change name and boundaries of the state. This is particularly mentioned in Article 3. Article 3 gives the power to center to change the boundaries of the state. Right to carve out one state out of another. For example, in 1950s, Andhra Pradesh was carved out of Madras. Establishment of states, State Reorganization Commission by center back then. Under this article, Parliament can form a new state, increase the area of any state, diminish the area, alter the boundary, alter the name. The right to change the boundaries of the state is clearly against the federal setup nature. Single constitution embodies rules, policies, laws, provision for both union and state. We do not have separate constitutions for state and union. We uphold one single constitution whose rules are applicable throughout India and in every state. Amendment procedure is same for both center and the state. Unified judiciary. Supreme Court and High Courts form a single integral judiciary. All courts have jurisdiction over the cases arising under the same laws. The civil and criminal laws are clearly and in detail laid down and are uniformly applicable to the entire country to ensure uniformity, placed under the concurrent list. Now we don't have separate laws for state or for the union. It is uniform throughout the territory of India. Office of the Auditor and Comptroller General, Article 148. The CAG of India is the organization managed by Indian Audit and Account Service Officers. Govern not only the accounts and auditing of the states but also the union. it operates the accounting for both state and the central government. Body under the complete control of center, no role of states here as well. Central organization gets in the financial working of states, making the center stronger. Now, use of central parliamentary police forces. Subject of police comes under the state list or this list second. To maintain law and order, states have their own agencies. However, sometimes these agencies amount to encroachment of jurisdictions. So, CRPF, BSF, CISF, these parallel agencies are under the parliamentary control to protect the properties and installations of the central government. So, all the features discussed in the previous video and this video proves that central government has more control than the state governments in our country, making our country or our constitution, or proving that we also uphold the features of a unitary form of government alongside the federal. That is why Casey Ware had came up with the phrase quasi-federal for our country. Thank you so much for watching both the videos. I hope you find it helpful. Do not forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe to our channel. See you in the next video.